So far, we've been spending a lot of time talking about the derivative of a function, thinking of it at a point, thinking of it as a function in its own right. We've been looking at f prime of a, which is the limit as x goes to a, of f of x minus f of a over x minus a. And often we write that as a limit in terms of h. And these mean the exact same thing. You just take h equals x minus a, and that converts them back and forth to each other. And we've been acting as if, well, of course, the derivative is there. But not every function has a derivative. In this video, we're going to look at the question of when does the derivative exist? So we say a function is differentiable at a point x equals a if f prime of a exists. This limit may not exist. If the limit doesn't exist, we just say it's not differentiable at x equals a, or sometimes we just get sloppy and say at a instead of at x equals a. Means the same thing. And we also talk about differentiability on an interval. Remember, we talked about continuity on an interval. Differentiability on an interval means that it's differentiable at each point in the interval. Okay. So, let's look at an example. Let's look at the function f of x equals absolute value of x and ask the question, is it differentiable? Or where is it differentiable? And the first step is to realize that the absolute value function is really a piecewise defined function. The absolute value of a positive number is just that number. The average absolute value of a negative number is just minus that number. And the absolute value of 0 is 0. So it's defined in pieces. And here's a graph of it. The piece when x is less than 0, the piece when x is equal to 0, the piece when x is bigger than 0. And so if we're going to figure out differentiability, we're going to have to do three separate calculations. We're going to have to do one calculation over here to see if it's differentiable when x equals is bigger than 0. And for that, we just need the first formula, because over to the right, f of x is just x. On the left, we use the third formula. F of x is minus x, whenever we're talking about negative inputs. And then we're going to have to do a bit of extra work to figure out if it's differentiable at x equals 0. So we check each region separately. So we start with the case of x bigger than 0. When x is bigger than 0, we're basically looking at this part of the curve. We don't care about the part where it's the other wing. We're just looking at this wing. So here we have a point A, and we're going to look at values of x close to A. Or if you prefer, we're going to take values of h that are smaller than A, so that A plus h is positive. Well, if A plus h is positive, f of A plus h is just A plus h. F of A is just A. And we can compute our derivative. The limit as h goes to 0 of this difference, a plus h minus a, the a's cancel, h over h, that's just 1. Well, that's no surprise. This part of the curve is a straight line, and it has a slope of 1. So of course the derivative is 1. But we didn't just eyeball it, we really checked it. We proved the limit existed. Then we look at the other side. We look at what happens when x is less than 0. Well, when x is less than 0, the absolute value of x is minus x. So f of a plus h is minus a plus h, and f of a is minus a. So our limit, f of a plus h minus f of a over h, is the limit of minus a plus h minus negative a, that's plus a, divided by h. The a's cancel, minus h over h is negative 1. So great, it's differentiable on the left with a derivative of negative 1. It's differentiable for positive values of x with a derivative of 1. What about at x equals 0? Or a equals 0. So f of a is 0. And now, no matter how small we take h, we can't use just one formula, because if h is positive, we have to use one formula. If h is negative, we have to use a different formula. So f of a plus h is f of h, which is the absolute value of h. So So we have to figure out the limit as h goes to 0 of absolute value of h minus 0 over h. In other words, absolute value of h over h. And how do you take a limit? Well, you take a limit from the right, you take a limit from the left, and you compare them. The limit from the right, limit as h approaches 0 from above, well, the absolute value of a small positive number is just h. Divide by h, you get 1. But if the limit as h approaches 0 from below, you're thinking of h equals negative 0.01, negative 0.0001, etc. Absolute value is minus h, so minus h over h equals negative 1. So the limit from one side is 1, the limit from the other side is negative 1. They don't agree. There is no overall limit. So this means that the function is not differentiable at x equals 0. Going back to our original picture, over here, f prime of x is equal to 1. Over on this side, f prime of x is minus 1. And at this point, f prime of x does not exist. So it's differentiable for all positive x, it's differentiable for all negative x, it's not differentiable at x equals 0. That's our example.